Wallah, I am hopeful from Allah. If the young man of today, you don't have that clash of emotions, but I'm hopeful if you can put an end to haram, and you can drop that DVDs, and you can get rid of that music, I'm optimistic from my kind Allah. He will give you no less reward than that what he gave to Sa'id ibn Jubair. This young man was then brought into the court of Hajjaj ibn Yusuf. Now listen to this chat. What a talk of chat room. We welcome you to the chat room where what your Allah forbid, your fantasies will be exploded. And I don't know what and what is happening. Listen to this chat. We welcome you to this chat room. You are live in this chat room, my brother. A chat between a young man who knew what life meant. He stood before Hajjaj ibn Yusuf. فَنَظَرَ إِلَيْهِ بِحِقْدٍ Hajjaj as a tyrant cast a dirty glance at Sa'id ibn Jubair. Masmuk, what's your name, young man? He said, Sa'id ibn Jubair. My name is Sa'id ibn Jubair. Sa'id means fortunate. Jubair was his father's name, which essentially means one who rectifies and reforms. One of the names of Allah Ta'ala is Jabbar. Jabbar commonly translated as mighty and authority, but it also means one who reforms and rectifies. So Hajjaj in his arrogance looks at this young man and says, you are not Sa'id ibn Jubair. You are not fortunate. You are Shaqi ibn Kusayr. Shaqi meaning you are wretched and your father is shattered. So Sa'id ibn Jubair says, بَلْ كَانَتْ أُمِّي أَعْلَمُ بِإِسْمِي مِنْ My youngster knows how to chat with a woman. And what they say, what replies are free. Or the answer, no, it's not free, it's nar, it's the fire of Jahannam. Wallah, it's not 20 ren and it's not 50 cent. Every reply, every SMS, every text is Allah's azab. Listen to this discussion and dialogue. He says, listen, Hajjaj, my mother knows my name better than you. My mother knows, my Nabi said, the greatest sacrifice, kalimatu haqqin inda sultanin jair, the proclamation of truth in the presence of a tyrant. There's nobody who has performed a more virtuous action. Fama taqulu fi Muhammad. What's your opinion of Muhammad? So Sa'id ibn Jubair said, which Muhammad are you talking? Ta'ni Muhammad ibn Abdullah salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayh. Are you referring to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He said, yes, I'm referring to. He said, well, then you must say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What's your opinion about Muhammad? He said, well, Sayyidu Wuldi Adam, the leader of the offspring of Adam. Sayyidu Wuldi Adam, An-Nabiyul Mustafa, the selected prophet of Allah. Khayru man baqiya min al-bashari wa khayru man mada, the noblest of the living and the noblest of the deceased. Hamal al-risala, embrace prophethood. Adda al-risala, discharge the obligation. Nasaha lillahi wa likitabihi wa li'ammati al-muslimina wa khassatihim. Faithful to Allah, faithful to the book of Allah, faithful to the general masses of the Muslims and to the rulers of the Muslims. Fama taqulu fi Abi Bakrin. What's your take on Abu Bakr? You know, a youngster, he goes on a chat for hours and hours. فَمَا تَقُولُ فِي أَبِي بَكْرٍ What's your opinion on Abu Bakr? He said, هو الصديق, the truthful, خليفة رسول الله, the successor of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, مَضَى عَلَى مِنْهَاجِ النَّبِيِّ followed diligently the life of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, لَمْ يُغَيِّرْ وَلَمْ يُبَدِّلْ did not alter himself in any way, عَاشَ حَمِيدًا وَقُتِلَ سَعِيدًا lived a noble life and died an enviable death. فَمَا تَقُولُ فِي عُمَرْ What's your take on Umar? هُوَ الْفَارُوقُ الَّذِي I wish my brother I was talking Arabic and you were understanding. I'm afraid that's not terminology that is common to us. Talk anything else and we understand. Unfortunately, the language of Quran has become an absent reality. هُوَ الْفَارُوقُ الَّذِي فَرَّقَ اللَّهُ بِهِ بَيْنَ الْحَقِّ وَالْبَاطِلِ He is that person through whom Allah separated and differentiated truth and falsehood. خِيَرَةُ اللَّهِ وَخِيَرَةُ رَسُولِهِ The selected of Allah and the beloved of his Nabi. مَضَى عَلَى مِنْهَاجِ صَاحِبَيْنِ Followed his Nabi and followed Abu Bakr. عَاشَ حَمِيدًا وَقُتِلَ شَهِيدًا Loved the noble life and died as a martyr. فَمَا تَقُولُ فِي عُثْمَانِ What is your take on Uthman? He said, أَلْمُجَهِّزُ لِجَيْشِ الْعُسْرَةِ The one who equipped the army of Tabuk. أَلْحَافِرُ بِئْرَ الرُّومَ The one who dug the well of Ruma and made the water available for the Muslims. المشتري لنفسه بيتا في الجنة The one who secured an abode for Jannah for himself in this very world. سهر رسول الله على ابنتي The son-in-law of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم on two of his daughters. Namely رقية and أم كلثوم. ولقد زوجه النبي بوحي من السماء My Nabi wedded Uthman to his two daughters according to divine revelation. Uthman was not his selection, that was the selection of Allah. And وَهُوَ الْمَقْتُولُ ذُلْمًا He was killed innocently and hence he is the oppressed Khalifa. فما تقول في علي. What is your take on Ali? He said, ابن عم رسول الله, the cousin of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. أول من أسلم من الفتيان, the first youngster to accept Islam. زوج فاطمة البتول, the husband of the pure Fatima. أبو الحسن والحسين سيدي شباب أهل الجنة, the father of the leader of the two youth of Jannah, Hassan and Hussein. Hajjaj said, now let's talk serious talk with you. فَأَيُّ خُلَفَاءِ بَنِي أُمَيَّةَ أَعْجَبُ لَكَ. We that is the Banu Umayyah, the rulers. Out of all the rulers, which one impresses you the most? He said, أَرْضَاهُمْ لِخَالِقِهِمْ. The one that has impressed is Allah the most, he impresses me the most. فَأَيُّهُمْ أَرْضَى لِلْخَالِقِ. Which amongst them, specify, be specific, which amongst them, I wish the youth of this ummah. Wallah, my brother, when you walk out arrogantly with your hair spike, and with that earrings, and with that attitude of yours, the riwayat of Bukhari, Nabi alayhi salam says, one young man was walking with pride and arrogance, Allah caused the earth to split. أَأَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ أَنْ يَخْسِفَ بِكُمُ الْأَرْضَ فَإِذَا هِيَ تَمُورُ. Do you feel you are out of the control and the grip of that Allah who is above you? Well, your actions denote that. What did he say? The one that pleased is Allah the most, that is the one that impresses me the most. Okay, be specific, which one has pleased Allah the most? He said, عِلْمُ ذَلِكَ عِنْدَ الَّذِي يَعْلَمُ سِرَّهُمْ وَنَجْوَاهُمْ. The one who knows the external and internal, he can decide that, I can't decide that. فَمَا تَقُولُ فِيَّ. Saeed, I want to ask you, what's your opinion about me? We know how a man mellows down to truth when it is boss, when it is seniors, when he's seen a job to secure. Yeah, his life is on the line, his neck is on the line. He said, أَنْتَ أَعْلَمُ بِنَفْسِكَ. You know yourself better. Why should I tell you about you? What must I tell you? بَلْ أُرِيدُ أَنْ أَسْمَعْ مِنْكَ. Saeed, I want to hear from you. What is your opinion about me? He said, إِذَنْ يَسُوءَكَ وَلَا يَسُرُّكَ. If you want to hear, brace yourself for something unpleasant. I'm afraid you're not going to hear nice things about yourself. Now go for it. What is it? إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ مُخَالِفٌ لِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ. تقدم على أمور تريد بها الهيبة وهي تقحمك في الهلكة وتدفعك إلى النار دفعا. You openly violate the orders of Allah. You are a tyrant, you are a dictator. Which, ya Allahu Akbar. You openly violate the orders of Allah. Your only aim is to impress upon the people your fear, that they must fear you. And that's going to land you in problems and ultimately in hell. So Hajjaj said, أَمَا وَاللَّهِ لَأَقْتُلَنَّكَ. You are provoking me and enraging me. I will kill you. You know, in Arabic, they say, آخر سهم في كنانة الملوك. The last arrow in a king's quiver is, I'll kill you. The last arrow in a king's quiver, when he resorts to violence, it's a dialogue. Now look at the word of this young man. My young brother, you can only talk like this if you don't talk to haram woman. Then this is the strength Allah will give you. He said, أما والله لا أقتلنك. Hajjaj said, I will kill you. He said, إذن تفسد علي دنياي وأفسد عليك آخرتك. If you kill me, you will destroy my life in this world and I will destroy your life in آخرت. I will have no life in this world, but you will have no life in آخرت. إنه, once upon a time, the youth of this ummah made this entire ummah proud. This was the legacy. Today we drop our gazes down out of embarrassment and humiliation looking at our youth. You go to any mall and see what our youngsters are doing. What did he say? إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَأْتِ رَبَّهُ مُجْرِمًا فَإِنَّ لَهُ جَهَنَّمْ. The Quran says, if you come as a criminal, there's no life for you. Hajjaj then tells him, اِخْتَرْ لِنَفْسِكَ أَيَّ قِتْلَةٍ شِئْتَ. Saeed, decide how do you want to die. Decide how you want to die. Saeed said, can I rephrase that question? Let me ask you, وَاللَّهِ مَا تَقْتُلَنِي قَتْلَةً إِلَّا قَتَلَكَ اللَّهُ مِثْلَهَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ فَاخْتَرْ لِنَفْسِكَ أَنْتَ يَا حَجَّاج. Hajjaj, the manner in which you're going to kill me, that is how Allah is going to punish you. Let me rephrase this, how would you prefer being punished in Akhirah? Don't ask me, how do I wish to be killed? Let me rephrase it. Whatever you do to me, so will it be done to you. Decide how you like to be punished. And that is how you kill me. He said, أَفَتُرِيدُ أَنْ أَعْفُوَ عَنْكَ. Okay, let's call it a close deal and I pardon you. He said, إِنْ كَانَ عَفْوٌ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. I don't fall for your temptations. If we conclude on pardon, it's the decree of my Allah. You've never pardoned me and you can never pardon me. أَسَّيْفَ وَالنَّتَعَ يَا غُلَامُ. Bring the sword and drop the mat and kill this wicked man. So he smiles. He smiles. Hajjaj says, وَمَا تَبَسُّمُكَ. One is that young man who smiles at a tyrant in his eye. That smile brings him close to Allah. One is the young man who has a smile flirting every woman. That smile only draws him closer to hell. What makes you smile, O young man? He said, عَجِبْتُ مِنْ جَرَاءَتِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَحِلْمِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ. I'm smiling looking at your arrogance and Allah's kindness towards you. I'm just marveling at how the clemency of Allah, the grace of Allah. You are getting arrogant upon arrogant, and Allah is just being calm and patient and displaying clemency with you. So he says, اُقْتُلْهُ يَا غُلَامُ, slaughter him. So he turns towards Qibla. إِنِّي وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ. Once upon a time, this is how the young man of this ummah died. Today my youngster is dying with a haram woman, with music blasting, going towards a club. Allah alone knows the destiny of this man. As he turns towards Qibla and he reads, إِنِّي وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي. I turn towards Allah. Hajjaj says, حَوِّلُوهُ عَنِ الْقِبْلَى. Turn the wicked man away from Qibla. So when they turn him away, he says, أَيْنَمَا تُوَلُّوا فَثَمَّ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ. Wherever you turn me, my Allah is there. Hajjaj says, drop him on the earth. When they drop him on the earth, he says, مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. From the sand we created you, to the sand we return you. Hajjaj said, slaughter this man. مَا رَأَيْتُ رَجُلًا أَدْعَى مِنْهُ لِآيَاتِ الْقُرْآنِ. I've never seen a human and a young man who understood Quran better than Sayyid ibn Jubayr. He lifted his hands. He said, Allah, I patiently persevere and happily accept this death, but I have a request, my Lord. اللهم لا تسلط الحجاج على أحد بعدي. Allah, let me be the last victim of Hajjaj. Allah, I think it's time you grab the hand of this tyrant. Allah, I think it's time you put an end and you seize him. Now, a tyrant like Hajjaj, on the dua of a young man, look at what Allah does to him. Hajjaj then mercilessly kills this person. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal said, وَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ قُتِلَ سَعِيدُ بْنُ جُبَيْرٍ وَمَا عَلَى الْأَرْضِ أَحَدٌ إِلَّا وَهُوَ مُحْتَاجٌ إِلَىٰ عِلْمِ. The death of Sa'id is such, it is not mourned by his family or by the nation. This entire earth today mourns the death of this young man. And I guess even the angels share in our grief today. Wallah, once upon a time the young man was such, on his death the entire world mourned his death. Wallahi laqad qutila Sa'id ibn Jubayrin. After that, this tyrant only had misery in his life. Cutting a long story short, when he died, someone seen him in a dream. They said, Hajjaj, how did you fare before Allah? He said, قَتَلَنِي بِكُلِّ قَتِيلٍ قَتَلْتُهُ قَتْلَةً وَقَتَلَنِي بِسَعِيدِ بْنِ جُبَيْرٍ سَبْعِينَ قَتْلًا. In lieu of every life I claimed, my Allah made me taste the agony of death once. But when I interfered with Sa'id ibn Jubayr, Allah said, you'll die 70 times.